In this video, you will learn the concepts related to current density and the continuity equation of current. So, the basic definitions of current density we will discuss. Then, continuity equation of current, which is based on the law of conservation of charge. So, we will find out those equations, the continuity equation, the integral form, and point form or the differential form of continuity equation. So, we will derive that. Now, the flow of current is defined as the rate of flow of charge. So, the electric charges in motion constitute a current. And the unit of current is in amperes, which is defined as the rate of movement of charges passing through a reference point. So, that is the basic definition of current. So, the current is defined as the motion of positive charges, although the conduction in metals takes place through the motion of electrons. So, in metals, the current actually flows because of the negative charges, because that means the motion of electrons. But the conventional direction of current, it is taken as opposite, that means corresponding to positive charges. Now, the current density is defined as the current per square meter, that is amperes per square meter. Now, let us assume incremental current delta I is crossing a surface delta S. So, there is some surface and some current is passing through this surface. So, current delta I and this is surface delta S. Now, if this current density is not in the normal direction, then in that case the current passing through this surface delta I, it will be the dot product between this J and delta S. Whereas if the current is passing exactly in the normal direction to this surface, so in that case I can simply take the product of this Jn, that is the normal component, multiplied by delta S. So, assuming that delta S is normal to the current density, we can say the current delta I, it is Jn multiplied by delta S. If the current is not perpendicular to the surface, then in that case it will be J dot delta S. And by taking integration over the entire surface, we can get the total current passing through this surface, that is I equal to surface integral J dot ds. Now, to derive a continuity equation, let us assume a small differential volume delta V here. So, it has a 6 surfaces for this volume, each surface of surface area delta S, and the length of each side it is delta L. Now, there is a charge density of rho V, coulomb per meter cube inside this volume. So, if I multiply this rho V by the volume delta V, that gives me the charge within this small differential volume delta V. Now, assuming this, now let us suppose this volume, it is moving in x direction, let us say by distance delta x. So, actually this is nothing but the moment of the charge. Now, based on this, let us write the equations for charge density and the currents. Now, the delta Q, the charge within this small differential volume, it is nothing but rho V into delta V. Delta V, that is this small volume, that is nothing but this surface multiplied by length. So, this is actually delta V. So, delta V into rho V, that is the charge within this small volume, and which is moving in the x direction. In the time interval delta t, it moves a distance of delta x. in the x direction. So the time required to move a distance of delta x is delta t. So this is the same equation just now what we have seen. This is delta v, that is the volume. Now within this interval delta t, the total change in the charge, it is delta q. So I can write this as delta q upon delta t. Delta q, it is the moment of the charge in the time interval, the delta t. So that gives me delta I, which is the rate of change of charge, that means current. So I substitute this here. So this is rho v delta s delta x upon delta t. Now here delta x upon delta t, that is the displacement divided by time. So this is nothing but velocity. So this I can write as vx. This vx, that is the displacement delta x in the time interval delta t. So that is velocity vx. Now in terms of current density, jx, that is the current in the x direction, it is nothing but rho v, that is the volume charge density, multiplied by velocity in x direction. Now from this equation, if I rearrange this as delta I upon delta s, so that is current upon delta s, so this is actually the current density. So this is nothing but rho v into vx. So delta I upon delta s, writing this as current density. Now that this current is flowing in the x direction, that's why this is the current density jx. So that is rho v into vx. Now in general, this current can be in any direction. So because of that, I can write j equal to rho v into v. So current density equal to volume charge density multiplied by v. Now this term is the charge in motion, because the charge rho v, and v is the velocity. So that is the charge in motion, and we call this as the convection current. This type of current is the convection current, and mostly this type of current flows in dielectrics or insulators. So J is equal to rho into V. So this is called as convection current density. Now let us move to the continuity equation of currents. For that, we start with the law of conservation of charge, which says that the charges can neither be created nor destroyed. Now let us assume it is the closed surface. Current is moving outwards, that means some charge is moving out. So if some charge is moving out, there must be some net decrease in the charge within this closed surface. So this is as per the law of conservation of charge. So that means the outward flow of positive charge must be balanced by decrease of positive charge within the closed surface. So I is the current flowing through this closed surface. So if this current is flowing outwards, that means it must be balanced by some decrease of positive charge. Now let us express this in terms of equation. So through this closed surface, if some charge I is moving out, now we know the current is defined as rate of change of charge. So if some charge is moving out of this, outside of this closed surface, that means there must be some decrease of charge within this surface. So that we express in terms of minus dqi by dt. Negative in the sign represents rate of change of charge is decreasing. So this is as per the law of conservation of charge. Equating this gives me this equation, I equal to surface integral j dot ds equal to minus dq by dt as per the law of conservation of charge. So this is the integral form of continuity equation. Now let us manipulate this equation and find out differential form of continuity equation. Okay. Applying divergence theorem, the surface integral can be expressed in terms of volume integral. So the surface integral j dot ds is nothing but volume integral of divergence of j. This is as per the divergence theorem. So our previous equation was surface integral j dot ds equal to minus d dt qy. So this was our equation as per the law of conservation of charge, that is the continuity equation in integral form. So surface integral j dot ds we have expressed in terms of volume integral like this. Now qi is nothing but rho v into dv, volume charge density into dv. So substituting here, so minus d dt, this is integral of this, that within the given volume integral rho v dv, that is qi. So substituting this here, I get this equation, minus d dt volume integral rho v into dv. Now from these two equations, volume integral divergence of j dv, taking on the left hand side, and from equation number 2, the right hand side of the equation number 2, I am writing here, and this equation I am substituting here. Now if we keep the surface constant, the derivative becomes the partial derivative, so it can be taken inside. Now both sides are volume integrals, so I can equate these two terms here, delta dot j is equal to this. So equating this two, delta dot j delta v, so delta v it cancels, so this gives me divergence of j equal to negative rate of change of volume charge density. So this is the point form of continuity equation. Now this is the differential form of continuity equation, what we have seen, delta dot j equal to minus d dt rho v. Now in case of steady state steady current, or that means the DC current or the direct current, the rate of change of charge, it will be zero. So for steady currents this is zero, so in that case this is divergence of j is equal to zero. For steady currents, this is the equation applicable. So these are the equations related to the continuity equation and the significance. So for a steady state current means, for such currents, the rate of flow of charge remains constant with time. The steady state currents have no sources or sinks. So this was about the continuity equation, the integral form, point form, and the differential form of continuity equation for steady state current.